Okay, so hello everyone. Today we'll be actually discussing some important updates and important information about the IAI examination. So this is the PDF which is shared by IAI and you all might have received in your mail, and it's also there in the IAI website, right? So I'll just quickly go through some important information which are there over here. First of all, throughout the examination process, remember to use your own registered email and contact number wherever you are communicating with IAI, right? And the examination link you will receive 2 days before the examination, the exam link on your email ID, the email ID which you have given to the IFOA website or the IFOA login. Okay, so moving ahead, there are a few requirements for the online examination which will happen, and these are the hardware and the software requirements which are there. The very first thing is you need your own personal desktop or maybe laptop. You'll need your own web camera, and there should be a microphone attached so that to your laptop or your PC, so that the proctor who will be managing the entire examination process can hear and see you properly. Also make sure you are also, there is also only Windows is required. iOS, MacBook are not allowed for the examination, and you require actually the licensed Windows 7 version or above Windows 10. If you do not have that, make sure you get it, because otherwise you'll not be able to use the software, the online examination software given by the IAI, right? After this, the MS Office required for your CM1, CM2 and CP2. These are the three examinations in which you, and CS1 and CS2. So CM, CS and CP2. These papers require MS Office licensed version of 2010 or above. Make sure it is a licensed one. If it's a pirated one, it will not work. And so make sure you get a licensed Office 2010 or above. Office 365 will also work here, right? Now these there are some of the functionalities which you will not be able to use during the process of your examination, which is your function keys. So all the F1, F2, all those keys till F9, then your escape key, right click of your mouse or touchpad will not work. So these three features will not work. Make sure whenever you are practicing in coming 10-15 days, you practice without the use of these three features or keys, right? These are the few packages which I have highlighted is for CS1 and CS2 examinations. Not all the packages are for CS1, like base, stats, utils, graphics, FPP. Till here, it's all about CS1, and after that, all the packages are for CS2. Now, the next thing over here is that you have to keep the room really empty. No one should be present in the room. Also, there should be no voice coming in because your proctor might ask for a 360 view of the entire exam room in which you are sitting. So make sure you are sitting alone. Also, there should be no reading material with you. Only reading material which you can carry is your table book and your prescribed calculator, pen and loose and white paper for your rough work. So make sure no other textbook is there in that room. Your gadgets like your mobile phones, smartwatch are also not allowed during the examination. Make sure these are not there in the room itself. Also, do not read the questions loudly, because then the proctor can question you, right? So all of these things should be kept in mind. Make sure the table book which you have, which you keep in your exam, during your exam, is clearly empty. That means you have not scribbled in your table book. The proctor might ask you to flip through the pages and show it to him, right? So it's mentioned that even if you are disconnected during the process of your exam, if you're disconnected maybe due to an internet issue, you can log into the portal, maybe within 5 to 7 minutes. And also one more thing is that your time will not be extended. If suppose there is an internet issue and you are logged out maybe for 5 minutes, you will not receive an extra 5 minutes. So this you need to keep in mind. So you need to keep a very good Wi-Fi, and also you have to keep a backup internet if you are giving your home giving your exam from your home, right? If you're not able to reconnect within 20 minutes of the exam, then please kindly call the technical support team. The number is also mentioned. I have highlighted here in the PDF. I will share it with you. It's below. So make sure you keep that number also handy, so that if there is an issue, such kind of an issue, please do call the technical team, because only they can help you during that particular point of time. Right? The next thing is, make sure no other tabs are open. That means you do not open any other website, anything else on any other Word document or any other PDF. These are not opened in your laptop, because all your screen movements and activities will be captured and recorded. If there is any wrong thing going on, then it might be taken into account and you might be disqualified for your examination, right? So let's come here about do's and don'ts. So basically, you need to keep your hall ticket. This hall ticket you will receive in your mail before your examination, and a government ID proof. This can be your Aadhaar card, PAN card, driver's license, whatever it is. It should be a government ID card. Make sure you keep it, because you will be asked to show it to the proctor. And you should keep the approved scientific calculator only. The list of the approved calculators are given below. Make sure you do not keep any other calculator, any other digital device with yourself. And the water bottle which you carry should be transparent. And make sure you keep the track of the timer which is there on the screen, available on the upper right of the screen. Because once the time is up, your last uploaded script will be taken as your final script. By this, we mean that if you're giving your CS1, CS2, CM1, CM2 and CP2, these examinations will happen in MS Excel or MS Word only. So if this is happening, if you have uploaded, suppose maybe half an hour back, your exam paper, and you have continued working for half an hour, you will lose that half an hour of work if you do not keep, if you forget to upload the paper, or maybe you lose out on time. Okay, this is there. Kindly uninstall the software if it is already installed from the last or the previous term which you appeared, because the software has been updated and you will need the recent software. Right, so you have to do that. All the links are provided in your IAI login. The moment you go to the IAI login, in the examinations tab, you will find September 2021 mocks. Click on that, and all the links about the different videos on how to install the software, how to work with the software, how to upload your answer script, everything, all the videos, short videos are given there. Make sure you go through those videos now only, so that you do not, so your exam is hassle-free, right? Okay, so you have to log in to your portal, which is your exam platform, 30 minutes before the start time. So suppose your exam is starting at 10 a.m., make sure you start logging in to the portal at 9:30, because it will take 15 minutes of time to verify your hall ticket, your government ID. So it might take time, because proctor will verify all the examinees' details separately. So you might have to wait for maybe 5 to 15 minutes. So make sure to do log in to the platform 30 minutes before to save this time. Otherwise, once the examination will start, your hall ticket and your government ID will not be verified later on, right? So this is a number which is there for any technical assistance. You can please copy down this number. It's also mentioned in the IEI login. Next, all of these four things you will require to be mentioned, which is your member ID, your name, your roll number. The roll number you will receive in your, again, IEI login. You can go to the examination tab in September 2021 examination. The roll number has been mentioned there. It will start with the paper you are giving. Suppose you are giving CM1, so it will start with CM1. Your name and your registered email ID, your member ID is nothing but the acted number which you have. the IEI number, sorry, which you have. So the profile verification will take 15 minutes, as I mentioned. Now, for CM and CS papers, for paper A, you will be allowed to work on the Word document. So in the portal, from the portal itself, you can open the MS Word. Make sure MS Word is a licensed version you have of Office 2010 or above. You can also use Office 365. There's no issue in that. But also make sure that the Office is loaded and installed in your in our default location, which is your C drive. So make sure you do it and make sure you give the mock examination so that you understand that how to open the Excel file and whether the Word file is opening correctly or not, all of these are happening smoothly or not. So for that, it's very important, and IEI is also conducting it, has completed the first mock and is also conducting a second round of mocks. So make sure you do that. For CS papers, for paper B, you need to copy paste the codes from the R to the Word file. And so again, in this case, you need to open the R Studio. So make sure, many of the students are facing this issue that they're not able to open the R Studio. In order to open that, you need to download the R executable file. Basically, when you download the R Studio exe file from the internet, it should be downloaded in a specific path. The path has been mentioned below. I've underlined it. I'll read it to you in the following part of the video. So make sure you do that, otherwise you'll not be able to access the R Studio through the online portal. So make sure you do it. And you also, when you appear for the mock examination, make sure this is happening. If there is any problem while opening the R Studio, please contact the technical team. Or the very first thing which you need to keep in mind is that the executable file, which is the R Studio executable file, is there in that particular specific path and location, which I will mention further. Okay. For all other papers, which is your CP1, CP3, SP and SA series, you have to work in the text editor within the exam platform itself. So you need not worry about any of the requirements of MS Office or any other things. For CP2, obviously, you will require again, the exam will happen in Excel workbook. So make sure you have again the licensed version of it. Make sure for CS, CM and CP papers, you take the last 15 minutes to upload your answer scripts. Why? Because otherwise your last updated or the last uploaded file will be taken as your answer script. So do not do that. Make sure last 15 minutes is only for uploading, because if there is any issue while uploading, your answer scripts will not be accepted through email, no matter what happens, right? So this is the roll number which you will receive. It will start with the paper name, which is CM1A or CS1A. So make sure you know this roll number, because you have to mention it on your mention it as your file name. So if you are writing in MS Word or MS Excel, make sure you save that Word or save that Excel with this particular name over here, with your roll number basically. And you also remember the path in which you are saving the files, because then while uploading, you will need to access these particular file, right? Okay, so next thing, moving on, is R Studio, which I was talking about. So this is the path, C drive, which I mentioned. C drive program files. The program files is the folder wherein you have to save the R Studio executable file, which is there, and then install the R Studio, because otherwise you'll not be able to access the R Studio through the examination platform. And many of the students are facing this issue. Please, and also you can click here to view the demo video. This link is also there in your IEI login. So the moment you log in into the IEI portal, there is one tab called examination, and within that there is some September 2021 mock examination. So you, in that tab, you have all the links given, 5 or 6 links given, which will help you to understand all these process very smoothly, right? Okay, so the next thing is that please upload the Word file itself. Do not change it into PDF format or whatever. Also, do remember to mention the file name as your roll number. Otherwise, it will not be taken as, it will not be considered for evaluation. Also, if it is found that the last modification time of a file is beyond the examination time, it will again be not considered for marking. So remember that you upload the script on time. Use of equation editor is absolutely, you can use equation editor. It's absolutely fine. It's entirely up to you whether you use equation editor or whether you want to type it down in the form of notations. And also 40% of the paper for CM1, CM2, CS1, CS2 will be MCQ. So you need not worry, because that 40% of the paper in the MCQ just have to mention the option name, which is A, B, C, D, and nothing else. You don't have to give any other description about it, right? So moving on, these are a few FAQs which were also given by IFOA. I'll just read through some important ones over here. So the very first thing is to understand whether your system is compatible or not, whether you have a proper Windows or licensed Windows 7 or above versions involved. So please, you can click on the link here which is given, so that you can access, you can understand whether your system is compatible to the online platform. This link, as I mentioned, is again given in the IEI login. Or this you might have received in your email, in your mail as well, right? 40% of the question paper will be MCQ, as I mentioned, for CS and CM paper A, not paper B, for paper A only. So it actually reduces a lot of burden of typing the mathematical equations, although you'll have to do it for the other 60% of the paper. Now, what is the duration of the entire examination? So all the paper A examination, which is CM1, CM2, CS1, CS2, paper A, and all other papers, CB1, CB2, and everything will be of duration 3 hours, 30 minutes. But the last 15 minutes is only for uploading. Make sure you do start uploading in the last 15 minutes. So you can consider the time being 3 hours 15 minutes and next 15 minutes to upload the paper so that you are on time. Otherwise, you can, this entire 3 hours 30 minutes is your entire exam time. You can type during this, or you can upload whenever you want to, right? For the paper B, which is CS1, CS2, CM1 and CM2B, paper B portions are 2 hours long. So again, by now 45 minutes you can think of typing, and next 15 minutes for uploading, because it's really, really, really important that you do not skip on the uploading time, because otherwise towards the end it will be really hassle. And if you face any issue at that point of time, then it will take you longer to contact the technical team as well, and you might not be able to upload your answer. So make sure that last 10-15 minutes you only keep for uploading and nothing else, because your 4-5 marks is not important over here. Your uploading and answering all the submitting all the other questions is more important, right? This is again the technical team number which is given over here, so make sure you have this. Okay, so you cannot carry any other material, anything which I mentioned as above. The passing marks is almost kept same as previous terms when you used to have examination in your pen and paper. This IEA has done, because IEA has also given this liberty of 40% MCQ for CM and CS papers, and they have set the exam in such a format so that you know you can complete it within the word on time, and they have also exceeded, they've also given you an extra 15 minutes of time. Earlier it was only 3 hours 15 minutes, now you have 3 hours 30 minutes to write down your paper, right? So moving on, as I mentioned, actuarial tables, you can use your own actuarial tables, but make sure you have it clean, you do not have scribbled on it anywhere. The next thing over here is that MS Office and R, it is strongly required that these are legitimate. As I mentioned, it should not be a pirated version. And if you face any issue during your examination, make sure you take the screenshots. If there is an internet description or any of such kind of issues which happen, make sure you take the screenshot of your entire screen so that you can show it to the IEI as a proof, right? Although try to avoid these kind of situations, keep a backup laptop, keep a backup internet connection so that you do not have these issues during your examination, right? If there is an issue on part of IEI's portal, they might extend the time or they might reschedule it, whatever. That's the very worst case scenario which is there. But again, you should keep yourself ready. Okay, so these are the few things which you can take a screenshot of these are the few things which you have to keep during your exam, which is your actuarial table, your scientific calculator, loose sheets for rough work, pencil, and make sure you have the government ID card for verification. It can be a Aadhaar card, PAN card, whatever it is. A water bottle which is transparent, and a backup hardware, which is basically your any particular PC, any. Now, make sure you do not have any personal consumables. You do not have your mobile phones, smartwatch, any other earphones, or maybe electronic, any other electronic gadgets should not be there, right? Okay. So you will receive the login credentials, as I mentioned, 2 days before your examination. So make sure receive that mail. If you haven't received the mail, just 2 days before, make sure you contact the IIT. Candidates who log in late after the start of the examination will not be allowed to write their exam. So as I mentioned, you should log in to the exam platform half an hour before. So if your exam is starting at 10, make sure you log in at 9:30 itself, because 15 minutes time will be taken to verify your hall ticket and your government ID proof. So make sure that your camera and microphone is also compatible with the software. To do that, there is again a link given. This link is also given in your IEI login, as I've mentioned. So make sure you do that. All these are the steps which have been given. You can do these manually by yourself, so that you can understand whether your microphone and camera is compatible or not. You can just click through or take a screenshot of this page and make sure you follow all the steps, right? Okay, so if there is any issue, so just click on the power button and your laptop is hanged, whatever it is, and you re-log in to the same using the same examination link. Do not stress yourself. You can use the same link again to re-log in within after 5 to 7 minutes once the issue is settled, right? Okay, so the next thing over here is, as I mentioned, as I talked about our studio, many of the students are facing this issue. So make sure you have the executable file within the C drive program file folder, so that you can open it directly from there. So these are the few things which are there. Make sure your Word and Excel are not password protected. If it is, then your answer script again will not be marked. So these are the few information. Now, these are the keys which are not working. As I mentioned, the function key, the escape button, and the right click is disabled during the examination process. So make sure you actually practice and do the revision without the use of these keys, right? And these are the alternative approach or the direct approach which you can use instead of the function keys, which you already are aware of. You will not have a mandatory requirement to use graphs and diagrams to support your answer. So basically, in your CB1, CB2, CB1, CB3, all of these papers will not require graphs, because it's not possible to draw the graph on board, right? So these were the small informations which are given and very important. Do remember, you follow all of these and keep all the things which are required during the examination, and you follow the process of your hardware checking, which is your camera, your microphone, your system compatibility, and you have a licensed version of MS Word, MS Excel if you're appearing for any CMCS and CP2 examination. And make sure you have a clean table book. Also, make sure you go through the IEI login September 2021 mock examination part, so that you go through all the just go through all the videos which are there, so that you understand how to give your examination. It's very, very important that you appear for the mock test as well, which is happening at this point of time, so that you are aware whether your system is compatible and you also understand how to work in that particular software. Also, if you have already pre-installed the software and it's there from your earlier examination, make sure you uninstall it and download the latest version of the software. So this is it. If you have any other questions, please you can leave it down in the comment section below, and we'll surely reply to your questions. Yeah, that's it, and Thank you so much for listening to the entire video. All the best for your examinations.